Hello everybody, my name is Michael Woodside and I'm an animator who wants to teach you how to draw some characters. Today is a special day and I made a special choice because of it. Today is April 9th, which is actually the 8-year anniversary of my first day at Disney. So I thought, what better way to celebrate that than to draw character of the first film I worked on, Wreck-It Ralph. So there he is right there. I'm excited to teach you guys how to draw this guy. He is a special dude to me because it was the first film I got to work on. And I was excited about that. So I have my bracelet on again today, too. I wore the same bracelet for Vanellope, but this is our bracelet we wore for the wrap party, which was on October 13th, 2012. So anyway, I have that on while we're drawing. For those of you who are new to this and are wondering who this is for anybody who is learning how to draw and wants to maybe spend a couple minutes not thinking about what's going on outside. So we are just going to take about 30, 45 minutes to learn how to draw Ralph, and should be a fun time. I will use simple shapes so you're able to follow along line by line. I go pretty slow, so hopefully you can track it. We're all going to be learning how to draw Ralph together, so there might be a moment where you feel like you want to throw away your drawing, and that is not what you should do. You should hold on to it and finish it, because usually by the end of it you have a pretty good idea as to maybe some things that you wanted to correct or wanted to go back and try again. But if you don't finish it, you kind of lose that opportunity to go back and assess. So be sure to give yourself a second to like study what you've done and then go back and do it a second time. There's no rush on this. We're just having a good time. I also like to sanitize my hands before we start working, because our tools are sitting around in drawers for a long time, and a lot of you are discovering that you don't have pencils, and maybe you're discovering some under the couch. Those are dirty, so clean your hands before we start working. The tools I'll be using today are just two pencils. It is this kind of maroon underdrawing pencil, and then I'll go back with my darker black for the final line. And I do two different pencils for my drawings so that you could see the construction, and then we'll build the final drawing separately. But if you want, you can all do it with one pencil or a crayon or markers, whatever you want to do. And I think that covers it. So we're just going to bring you over here to the table and get started. Cool. Okay, so if you've done this before, you know what we're about to do. We're going to do some warm-up circles on the side of our page over here. Find some Ralph specific music on here. Not that Cinderella's bad, it just doesn't feel appropriate right now. Let's do this. Yeah. So we're gonna actually do a little different than we normally do for our main character construction, but I still wanna work with circles even though we're gonna change it up a bit. So a couple of reasons why we do this. Our first thing we want to do is warm up and kind of get a sense of how to draw again and teach your arm how to move. What I'm doing while I move my arm is I'm moving my whole arm and not just my wrist or my fingers, and that helps me try to find some consistency in the lines I'm doing. And this is sloppy, this isn't meant to be anything. So that's the second thing this does, is that helps kind of cure the blank page syndrome, because already I have a bunch of junk all over the page that doesn't look very good, but it's just a matter of getting warmed up. You can't really go wrong with these drawings, especially when we go in knowing that we're learning. So I'm gonna go in with this darker pencil to show you what happens when we start putting our final line in. Once we do that, you might notice that the kind of maroon lines that I have back here, they sort of start to fade away, and our focus is drawn directly to these darker lines. So we can do whatever we want underneath here, and then that'll help help us find the shape. So I think a lot of people assume that to draw, you need to know exactly what you're doing from the beginning and then just do that thing. And it's very rare that anyone has that kind of sense of what they're doing. So I'm not one of those people, so we can fail together. You can see that clearly. Cool, let me sharpen this and then we're gonna start. Okay, like I said, right away it's gonna be different. Normally what we wanna do is we'll start with a circle, like if you remember when we drew Mickey. He's the circle with the construction lines. Ralph, he lives in an 8-bit world, and 8-bit means it's pixels, and pixels are squares. So a lot of his design language is based on something different than circles. So we still did these circles because we're gonna use them later, but the first thing I wanna actually start off with is a square. So we're gonna put that, we're just drawing Ralph's head, so we're gonna put the square a little low because he has kind of tall hair, but he has a big chin too. So I'm gonna put it kind of right in the middle of the page. And it doesn't need to be perfectly straight square. It would help if mine was, so I could teach you best. But... okay, so this is gonna be the top of Ralph's head. See, it's our first building block. Crazy. And then now we're gonna do the second square, which is gonna be a little bigger than this top one. And if you're good at math, you know that squares are the same length. Each line is about the same length, so for making this longer, then this is going to be about as long, not as long, and kind of close. It's okay to be rough. He's not this kind of like perfect rigid thing, but this is just a fun way to get started. And then I give you guys a chance to set that up. Two big blocks. I started in April of 2012, and I remember it must have been in March or February. We were at the Disney, in California Adventure, the animation station, and they had a big display for Wreck-It Ralph, and I stood in front of it forever, dreaming that I could work on that film because I knew I was applying soon, and. When I got that phone call, I was at my other job, and my friends who were also there took pictures of me collapsed on the ground like a baby. Okay, so enough of that. Let's do our center line. So our center line, just like we did before, we just want to have it go straight down the middle of both of these squares. So I'm just going to draw mine really lightly, and I move my whole arm, and I try to do it in one quick stroke so it's not slowly moving through. One of the cool things why we talk about why we have the structure set up is that in the first, I guess it was last week, we drew Vanellope, and she is a lot of really round shapes, right? And Ralph, he's based more on this design language that's indicative of his video game. So his video game is one of the older 80s games, and it has this great, corners and feels like little pixels. So that's what we're doing here. Let's go ahead and kind of soften him up just a little bit. So what I'm gonna do for that is I'm gonna start towards the bottom of this square and just slowly move a rounded line out to this corner. And then I'm gonna bring that all the way down here and round it out there. I've kind of done the same thing all the way around. And I'm keeping the roundness pretty shallow because I don't want it to be another circle down here. It's more like that eventually. So and it connects up here to the same. So for my drawing, I'm going to darken this up so you can see what the end result hope is. Like I said, once we go in with a darker pencil, these lines aren't going to matter as much, just to help us get started. And a lot of times, if an animator is going to draw like this, it's just as they're learning how to draw the character. Once they get it, they're not going to do this kind of construction. It's sort of built into their memory, their muscle memory. Okay, so let's go ahead and put his nose in there. So his nose, if this is a circle, his nose is like a squash circle. It's an oval like that. And it sits right here in the middle of this, but these 2 points meet. So I'm gonna draw that here. Just wanna see the size that I'm drawing it before we start yours. His eyeballs, he has these two little eyeballs that are pretty close together. Funny, when you look at this on its own, it kind of looks like Mickey's nose. So the eyeballs are really almost perfect circles that are right above the nose and pretty close to that middle line. Years flies by at Disney. Every time you hit a milestone, the milestones are like 1 year and 5 years, 10 years, you get a pin. And this is my 5 year pin that I got in 2017. That was right after Moana, I believe. So
it's Pluto. You can see it. Focus on it here. Pluto.
So in a couple years, I'll get another milestone. I believe it's a plaque or something at 10 years. We'll see. Okay, so for his eyebrows, we're gonna go back into some straight lines. So his eyebrows, if we want, let's just do a straight line across here really lightly. And then another straight line, pretty big, right above that. And just outside the eye on this side, I'm just gonna drop it down into like a V over here. Same on the other side, V. And then on either side of the center line, he doesn't have just one eyebrow, he has two eyebrows, so I wanna add some vertical lines in here to kind of separate those eyebrows from each other. So I'll go ahead and darken those lines in as you catch up. I had so much fun working on Ralph. When I started at Disney, I was what was called an animation assistant or assisting animator, I always forget. And that is somebody who works with the crowds, the background characters. So I was animating background characters on Ralph. Got to animate a couple of shots of Ralph. There we go. But not too many, which is good because I'm still learning. Okay, so now I want to give him his big smile. So on this square, the sides of the square here, I'm going to draw a big U shape. I don't know if you can hear it, it's raining pretty hard out there right now. So that's the beginning of our smile. It's the top lip. Peter Pan music. Okay, and then now we're going to do the bottom of the mouth. So the bottom of the mouth is another U, it's just much bigger. So it's going to go all the way down here. Probably made mine too big. The U that I'm going to adjust to is a little flatter on the bottom than it is than what I drew. So it's more like that. Kind of similar to this rounded line. can see. I'm a professional, guys, and I'm still making mistakes over here trying to figure it out. So, if you haven't made a mistake yet, you're better than me. I just made this a little wider. I'm gonna give him, now that we know the mouth corners are, I'm gonna give him some little cheek lines. Like that. Now that we have those cheek lines, I wanna kind of assume that this cheek is being pushed up because the mouth corners are being pushed up, and that there might be little lines right there under his eyes. See how this is all related? So now I'd like to give him his teeth, which are another U shape, more towards the top. And right at the middle, where we had that center line, I'm going to draw a V, because he's got a little separation between his teeth right there. Lastly, I want to give him his tongue. We've drawn a couple different characters' tongues in the past, and this one is pretty similar to the others. It's a rounded M shape like that. And the center of that is right here at the middle line. So now I kind of want to round off his hairline. So right in the middle of his head, I'm going to draw a U. But the lowest point of that U is right at the center line. And then I'm going to darken the top of the square. But before I get to the corner, I'm going to make another rounded shape that goes like that. And you just darken straight down to the bottom. Right here. Around that corner. Right. Before we move on past that, I want to give him his nostrils. So the easiest way I know how to do that is just draw these little ovals right border the bottom of the nose circle. I'm gonna color that in now, but we'll color that in again with a darker pencil, but I just want to show you how that looks like that. And then I'm just gonna sort of indicate this is all the top of the nose, so I'm just gonna do a quick line like that. Just showing you here how that works. So I've done this before on other characters where we want to darken the top of the eyes just to sort of indicate that there's some eyelashes. So he doesn't have long flowing princess eyelashes, he just has some natural lashes. We want to still show those. I learned so much while I was working on Ralph. I feel like I learned more while working on that film that I learned in all of my schooling combined. And that's not about schools not being good, it's just about something about professional deadlines really, really push you to grow. So I did not anticipate that, but it was a really big growth experience for me. I'm gonna test something out on my drawing just to see. Oh, sorry. Okay, I was gonna see if it was better if I shorten this, or maybe I can cut off more of the corner in mine. Let's just see. Yeah. Sure. I never really erase, I just just mess around with the shapes until I find something that works. So I'm going to choose to do this rounded off one. You can do the more squared one. It's fine. Either way is good. I just wanted to try anything. Let's start with his hair. Well, you know what? I changed my mind. We're going to do the ears. The ears are, other characters might have ears like this. This is the head. Big ears. Hello. Or Dumbo's ears were crazy. His ears are just like the other things. They're more squared boxes. So I'm just going to start here in the middle of the head and kind of push him out. And he's got really long ears until we put his hair on, and then they feel the right length. But I'm just going to give him some big boxy ears. It's going to look like a monkey for a little bit, but we'll fix it pretty quickly. So again, I'm just going to slightly round out those corners so they're not totally sharp. Okay, he has these really thick sideburns that are going to help us. So about halfway between where I stopped this line and the hair, I'm just going to draw a straight line that goes down and then some little hairs. Same on the other side. So now his hair has these kind of cool diamond shapes. So I'm just going to start drawing the first diamond, which is here. This is why we left all the room at the top of the page. So he's got one diamond right in the middle. And then three on each side. One, two, three. So he's going to start, they sort of overlap each other. That's one. This is the longest one right in the middle. Two, three, like that. Same on the other side. I'm gonna give you guys a second for sure to catch up because these are interesting shapes. So again, it's one diamond right in the middle. And then these over here, again, I'm going to soften up, help them feel like hairs. I'm just adding these little lines that go through to show this hair. So before we move on past the hair, there's two little diamonds that we need to draw in our little triangles. And they're behind this big piece and these next pieces. So they're smaller. They just kind of come out here. They help fill in that area. Because from the side, Ralph has... Oh, there we go. There's his hair here. But he has a lot of hair back here, too, that sort of feeds into all that. So these hairs are just a little farther back in space. So the last thing I want to add on his head is this, his eyeballs. So I'm going to do these circles that are kind of hanging out on the bottom of the drawing, and the bottom of the eyeball circle. Try to make sure those are the same size. And then his pupil with a... We always put the shine in there if we can. It's gonna look a little crazy. So just to finish him off, I want to add his shoulders. So right about, right below the mouth, you can just draw a straight line out this way. Going all the way through, because you'll see when we darken it, it's fine. And then just kind of darken the parts that are outside of his neck. And then add some rounded lines for his shirts. So he's got this sort of a half circle shape underneath that goes around his chin. Back up. And the very last shape that we'll add is, I don't know how else to describe it other than a stethoscope. If you've been to a doctor's office, you know that the doctors, they wear that thing around their neck that when they listen to your ears, it's this shape. Sorry, they listen to your, they don't listen to your ears, they listen to your heartbeat, and they have these little things in their ears. So the stethoscope shape is just right here. He doesn't have a stethoscope, this is just the outline of his outer shirt, right there, into the middle, then back up here. Ralph is not a doctor. So this is an undershirt and this is his outer shirt here. Okay, let's go ahead and darken some lines. So if you've done this show before, you know that I am a right-handed person, which means I will darken my lines from the left to the right side of the drawing so that I don't smudge my hand across. So, this is really the leftmost area, the hairs. So already by doing this, it sort of helps take the focus away from all of my scratchy figuring it out lines. Just adding some little tufts of hair in here. Light or darkened everything on the right side of the page, so I'm sure I'm gonna smudge. There's a trick for avoiding that as well, so I'll be happy to show you guys when we get there. So the shot that the one shot that I animated of Ralph, when I started, they had already finished the sequence where Ralph breaks Vanellope's cart to help her, but she doesn't know that. And there's one last shot right at the very end that hadn't been animated yet, and it was Ralph walking by the broken cart and picking up the candy heart that Penelope made for him that says, "You're my hero." And no one had animated that yet, and that got given to me, and I was terrified, because a lot of what I had animated up to that point was background characters. I'm going to add some little... little hairs here at the end. These are just quick vertical lines there. So I animated it, and it's a shot where Ralph is walking up and picking up the thing. But so it's mostly what we would call a physicality shot or a mechanic shot, and that just means that the focus of the shot is making sure that the mechanics of the walk feel natural and feel believable for that moment. and I was having a very difficult time with that. I'll show you real quick before I finish that story. This is how I protect the drawing from getting smudged, is I just cover it with a sheet of paper. Well, my hand is there and I can move my hand around, but it's not gonna smudge anything. So, the leader of that sequence, is the supervisor for the sequence, his name was Tony Smead. It still is Tony Smead. He's a great man. He was co-head of animation for Zootopia and Frozen 2. So one of my leadership heroes at work, and because of what happened here. So I was walking to his office basically to tell him they should let me go because I don't know what I'm doing. And I don't want to ruin the movie because the scene was already so great. And I felt like my animation of Ralph walking and picking up the thing was ruining it. And I was like, you guys would be better off without me. I was down as artists can be. And so I walked in there telling him that, you know, maybe you should let me go. And he's like, no, hold on, sit down for a minute. So we took a look at the scene together. And he encouraged me and let me know that I really wasn't as far off as I thought I was. Kind of pointed at a couple specific things that I needed to work on, like for instance, how the foot was picking up from the ground and how the knees were related to that. Just really tactile, kind of noodly animatory things. But they made sense to me, and he encouraged me to be, to know that I was almost there and I was as capable as anyone else at the building. And that changed everything for me. I walked into that room ready to quit, and then I walked out literally thinking, I can't believe I'm a Disney animator. And I think it's people like that that really shine. Leaders like that who encourage you and help build. Those are always my favorite. So anytime I have an opportunity to help in a leadership capacity, I feel like that's the job, is to give people the confidence to know that they already can do what they're trying to do. They just need maybe some fresh eyes on it. And fresh eyes just means somebody who hasn't had to stare at it at a computer all day. So you can kind of go blind to what you're working on. So even for these drawings that you're working on, if you work on it for too long, you might not have a good grasp of what you're even trying to do. And you could show it to somebody who hasn't seen it, and they might be more capable of telling you, oh yeah, it looks like the ear might be a little too big. And you're like, you know what, now that you say that, I see it. So he did it in a really caring way, and I was very grateful to him for that. Because I was ready to quit. You can't imagine what would have happened. Let's go ahead and do the nose. Put the sheet paper down. A lot of times when I'm drawing an arc, I want to push away from my hand like this instead of pulling, and it feels a little less less controllable. So when I went to do this top lip, I know that if I pull towards me, it's going to be a little weird. So I'm going to rotate the drawing around. So if you have just, you're drawing on a flat sheet or a flat desk, you can just turn it, and I'm going to cover this part so I don't smudge it. Then start pushing away. So I know, just for how I've learned how to draw, this is easier for me. Let's go ahead and, while we're here, we'll do the teeth. funny, whenever I talk to people about animation, everyone seems a little amazed that professionals struggle with doubt and questioning themselves, and I feel like that's constantly happening. So it's always funny when someone says, "Oh, I didn't realize that it was that you guys struggled with that as well." Like, that's almost exclusively what we do, is just constantly second guessing ourselves. And I think it's because we want to do the best thing that we can, and that self-doubt causes you, I think it's healthy at times, because you're taking a second to say, is this the best version of the thing, or is there another way to do it better? And I think that's healthy. As long as you don't move to, I'm awful because this isn't good yet. That's the dangerous place to be. But questioning if you've made the right choice or not in the animation or in your drawing or design, that's normal. But just don't take it personally. You are not your drawing. You're a lot more than your drawing. And this is supposed to be fun, remember? So don't get too mad at yourself. If at some point during this drawing you wanted to throw it away and give up and watch Tiger King, don't. I mean, it's good, but don't give up. Cool. So rather than doing like coloring it in with the exact right colors, I'm just going to use my underdrawing pencil to color it in with different shades. So for instance, let's go ahead and do the hair. It's going to be darker. And when I color in things, I like to color in using the same direction on my hand so that I'm not changing in the middle of an idea. And that's typically based on the part of the structure that I'm coloring in. So right now I'm coloring in the sideburns, so I'm choosing to go vertically for that. But for this hairpiece on that one, I'm going to go horizontally. So I think it'll still be fine. Mm-hmm. I'm also using the side of the pencil because I can cover more real estate that way, and it's a little smoother. So basically for each of these hair pieces, I want to color in the direction of the hairs. So the hairs are going out this way. I want to start thinking about forms in three dimensions. Because even though Ralph, the Wreck-It Ralph character, is a sort of a two-dimensional character in the video game, when he looks like this, he is three-dimensional, so we want to think about him in space. So again, the hairs are going out this way, so I can darken some of those. And this is pointing out this way, so I'll do that here. We got to see John C. Reilly a couple times around the studio when he was working on Wreck-It Ralph. He always had a cool hat on, like a straw hat. He's a funny guy. He added a lot to the character. I mean, most voice actors do. But he's a fun guy to animate. There's a lot of, if you just turn the movie on, and it's hard to say this as an animator, but even not looking at it, if you just close your eyes, you can hear some really cool stutters in his performance as he's trying to figure out what he's trying to say. And that's always really fun to animate, because as animators, we're trying to find the thought, and we're trying to understand who the character is through the thought process. And Johnny gave us a ton to work with. Probably this back one's a little darker because they're farther away. the color in the eyebrows. They're just going to be a little darker. Really lightly coloring in the nose. The nose is usually a little darker than skin tone. Not by a lot. In fact, while we're there, we can color in his eyes, avoiding that little circle for the highlight. Something I like to do too is really lightly just coloring in kind of the space, basically the eye socket, between the eyebrow and the eyeball. With red first, and I might come back in later and add some of my regular gray pencil on top of it, because I want it to be different than the tongue, and the tongue will be red. If you feel like you are coloring in something and you're not getting it right, and you need to try to figure out why it's not going right, this is a good place to figure out. So you can just do some practice strokes over here. This is sort of your scrap paper. So I didn't really get to animate much on Wreck-It Ralph 2 because I was working on Frozen 2 at the time. The whole system works in that whoever's working on the film after the next film has to start on that a little earlier to help prepare that for the animators. And so I was working on Frozen 2 while they were working on Wreck-It Ralph 2. I got to do a little bit. I got to do some crowd cycles and characters cheering, and it's used throughout the film, but I didn't get to do any full animation work on it. We had messed around with ideas for the end credits, but ultimately, I had to move on to Frozen. So I'll do this tongue really lightly. I think that's fine with... I'd even shade in the teeth with this red a little bit. Just kind of starting from the side and then fading out as I get to the front. Shading the inside of the ears. So his shirt, his outer shirt, is orange red, so it actually works well for our pencil that we're using. So I'm just gonna kind of on the outside start really, really rough and loose. It doesn't need to be refined because it's not going to be, since it's fading out at the bottom, you can sort of lose the detail as you go. Two last little lines I want to add. They're going to go right above his eyebrows. If you see him from the side, his eyebrows kind of are these blocks. So we haven't done the top part of the block, and I drew it really dark here, but it's going to be light, just kind of following the same line. done a couple shading things for myself. You don't even have to if you don't want to. I'm just thinking the light's coming from up here, so having a little bit of extra detail, darkening in the hairs. Ralph was a very special film to me when it came out, and I was so excited when I got to see it in theaters and finally hear people react to it, and probably saw it like 4 times in theaters just to experience it with an audience. You can always find animators and other filmmakers at the movie theaters when the movie comes out, because they want to hear how people respond to it. It takes forever to come out, so it's cool to finally be able to experience it with people. And that was an exciting time. Still is every time we get to see a movie with an audience. Okay, before we're done, you know what we do. We sign it. I'm gonna sign mine down here. And that is Ralph. I'm gonna move us back over here. Get ready. There you go. Checking that we're working, and before we move on, I'm gonna start sanitizing my hands because we're done drawing now. Thank you for spending my workiversary with me. It's weird to be at home for it, but you know, we're all at home, and drawing Ralph makes me feel like I'm back there. Something exciting tomorrow, at the time that we normally do the class here, the class will be on the Good Morning America Instagram live feed. I'm gonna take over their Instagram live feed, and we're gonna be drawing Sven together, a different pose than I did for Disney Animation, so find me there. And then, after we're done with Good Morning America, probably about 1 o'clock Pacific time, so 4 o'clock Eastern time, I'll put up the new social drawing with Woodsy here on the YouTube channel. So 2 classes tomorrow, bonus for the weekend. I'm glad that we spent this time together. Don't forget, if you want to share your drawing, use the hashtag drawing with Woodsy, and that's where I can find it on Instagram or Twitter. It's fun to reminisce about the Wreck-It Ralph year. So thank you for joining me and humoring me as we talked about that. Again, just because we're separated doesn't mean we need to be alone, and I'm happy to spend my workiversary with you. So thank you very much, and I'll see you tomorrow twice. Bye now.